Welcome to another hands-on. In this lesson, we're going to create a VPC endpoint. It's going to be a gateway endpoint, and we're going to use some policies to see how we can control access to an Amazon S3 bucket. So this is basically the configuration. We already have a VPC and a public subnet, and we've got an instance running in it from earlier on. Now, we're going to create an Amazon S3 bucket. I'm getting ahead of myself a little bit here because we actually cover S3 in a lot of detail in the next section. If you're completely unfamiliar with it and you want to get a primer, you could flick forward. But we won't be doing too much here. It's going to be fairly straightforward stuff. Now, when we create our endpoint, a route will be added to our route table. And that will point to a destination, which will resolve to the IP addresses of Amazon S3. Now, what happens is this is a more specific route than any other route, like the route going out to the internet. So it should follow this path, which means any connections that go to the AWS S3 endpoints should be routed via the gateway endpoint. And we'll be able to prove that that's happening and that we're not using the public internet. So we will modify the policy here to do that. You'll see what I mean shortly. And on the S3 bucket, we'll add a policy. Now, bucket policies are basically just resource-based policies. It uses JSON language, just like we do with IAM policies, but we just use them to control access to our buckets. So we apply them directly to the bucket rather than to a principle like an identity-based policy. The first thing to do is to head over and create the VPC endpoint. I'm in my management account in North Virginia. On the left here, under endpoints, we can create an endpoint. Let's click this button, create endpoint. And under services, if we put in S3 and search, we get these options. We're going to choose gateway for Amazon S3. Now we need to specify which route table to actually update. Now, as you can see, the route table for our VPC, the custom one, is not there. That's because we need to make sure we specify our custom VPC. Now we can see our route tables. And I'm going to choose the one that's the main route table. So that's the one associated with my public subnets. Now, the policy by default is full access. So we have a statement here that's action, any action star, effect, allow, and then any resource and any principle. So it's very open, but you can customize that. So let's just create the endpoint, and it's being created for us. So here is our endpoint. Now, what we want to do is go to route tables and just make sure that the route table has been updated. So that's this one here, the main route table for our custom VPC. Under routes, we can now see that we have the destination, and this is going via a VPC endpoint. So that's the route to Amazon S3 going via the endpoint. So that's set up correctly. Another thing we need to do, we're going to run some commands against Amazon S3 from our EC2 instance. So I need to give it some privileges. I'm going to create a role. So let's choose create role here in the IAM service. Common use cases is going to be EC2. So we're going to allow EC2 to call an AWS service. For permissions, just type in S3 and search, and we're going to give full access. I'm going to copy the name of this policy, and we're going to use that for the role name as well. So let's just paste that in, create the role. And now we have a role that we can assign to our EC2 instance. So over in EC2, let's choose our instance, go to actions, security, modify IAM role, and we're going to choose a role, and we should see it in here. And there it is, Amazon S3 full access. So let's save. And our instance now has the privileges it needs. Over in the Amazon S3 console, which you can find under services and storage, we're going to create an S3 bucket. So a bucket is just a container into which we add objects. Objects are files and videos or whatever you want to add. I'm going to call mine DCT VPCE test, and it's going to be in North Virginia. I can scroll down, don't need to change anything else at this point, and create this bucket. So now that we have a bucket, we can add some objects. Objects, as I say, are just files. This is an object-based storage system. So we can come in and add files. I'm just going to add a couple of JPEG images and upload. So simple as that, we have some files on Amazon S3. Now let's come back to EC2, choose our public 1A instance, go to Instance Connect, and connect. Now we haven't specified any policies yet, but let's just check that we can connect to Amazon S3. So now we should be able to run commands against S3. Let's try running AWS S3 LS and hit enter. And we can see our buckets. We should be able to run AWS S3 LS and then S3:// and our bucket name as well. And if we hit enter here, we should see the contents of the bucket. So at the moment, everything is working great. Now, how do we know this is going over the endpoint rather than going over the internet? Because we are in a public subnet. Well, let's go back to our endpoint. With my endpoint selected, I'm going to choose policy. I'm going to copy this code here in the endpoint policy, choose custom, paste it in, and let's just change the policy to deny. So this should deny everything. Now, if we're going via the internet, this shouldn't make any difference. But if we're going via the endpoint, then this should block access. So back on our instance, let's try and rerun that command and we get an access denied. Let's try and run the LS command. Again, we get an access denied. So it's definitely not working. Back in my endpoint, I'm just going to change this back again because I don't really want that to deny me from access at this point. So let's just go back to full access, click on save. The next thing we're going to do is set up our bucket policy. And the bucket policy is going to prevent any access except from the VPC endpoint. And that's something that comes up in a lot of exam scenarios. So let's go into our bucket here, go to permissions, come down to bucket policy, click edit, and I'm going to copy the bucket ARN. Now, this is the bucket policy. So it's in your code, Amazon VPC directory, bucket policy VPCE. What you need to do is take this whole ARN here and just paste your correct ARN over the top for your bucket. And there's two options here. One is without the slash star and one is with. So the one with the slash star means that you can also look at the objects within the bucket. Now, the last thing we need here is the VPCE ID. So back at my endpoint here, I'm going to copy the endpoint ID and then come back and paste that into my policy. So that's it. This policy should now apply. Now, what does it do? Let's have a look. The policy is a deny. So it's going to deny any principal, any S3 action on these resources specifically, if the condition does not equal this VPC endpoint ID. So in other words, if you're not coming from this VPC endpoint ID, you're going to get denied. If you are coming from this VPC endpoint ID, it doesn't apply. So let's copy all of this code to our clipboards. And back in the bucket policy editor here, I'm going to paste it all in and just save these changes. So let's go back and make sure we haven't broken access. Back on our instance, let's try to run the AWS S3 LS command and we see our buckets. Let's check that we can see inside our bucket and that works correctly. Now that's good because this instance is coming from the VPC endpoint. So again, we've proven we're coming via the endpoint. But the other thing we can do is check from our own computers and we shouldn't be allowed access. So back in a terminal here, I'm going to run AWS S3 LS and I do see the buckets. But what about if I try to see inside the bucket? So the full command is AWS S3 LS S3:// and then your bucket name and hit enter. So I've got an access is denied. So that proves that I'm not able to access the bucket from my computer because I'm not coming via the endpoint. Now let's just go back to the console and have a look at the bucket. In the bucket here, you can see that we no longer have permissions to this bucket. We've actually locked ourselves out because I'm actually coming through the console here and the console doesn't come via the endpoint. Now that is it for this lesson. We have finished with the EC2 instance and the VPC endpoint. With the endpoint, you can simply select the endpoint, go to actions, and then delete endpoint. And that should clean up the entry in your route table as well, but you can always just go and check. You might need to refresh the page, and then it has gone. So once you've done that, terminate your instance, and we've finished for this lesson.